हेलो नमस्कार एंड आदाब टू ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम योर फ्रेंड एस्ट्रोलॉजी एंड गाइड इरफान वंस मोर विथ यू फ्रॉम योर वेरी ओन चैनल एस्ट्रो एश्योरेंस। इट्स नॉट इजी टू डिसाइफर व्हाट द रिजल्ट्स ऑफ वेरियस हाउसेस इन द हॉरोस्कोप कैन गिव अस, स्पेशली व्हेन प्लैनेट्स आर प्लेस्ड इन अदर साइंस दैट देयर ओन आर प्लेस्ड इन कंजंक्शंस इन योगास इन दोशास अंडर एस्पेक्ट्स। इट्स नॉट सो इजी एंड हेंस it is sometimes difficult and tricky to be able to analyze and decipher what kind of results that probable effects can come through various placements. It becomes more challenging when we are entering into a more confusing area. That confusing area is when planets which rule two houses rule a dusthana and maybe a trine or a kendra house. Then how do we analyze the results? And even if it's not a dusthana or a trine house or a dusthana or a kendra house, but even a upachaya house and a trine house or a upachaya house and a kendra house, then too how do you decipher the results of planets when they rule two houses? So let's deep dive into how planets which rule two houses can give you results. Firstly, a simple rule: the planets when they rule a dusthana, irrespective of where they are placed, how they are placed, what doshas they are placed in, or what yogas they are placed in, they will give you challenges, they will give you issues, there will be problems, upheavals, transformations depending on which house it is. You cannot escape that, and that is a balancer in a horoscopes. The reason why it is a balancer is that you get to understand happiness only when there is a lull in between, either a neutral period or a challenging period, and then when the success comes to you, it is sweeter. A good health is appreciated more when you have gone through a bout of sickness. So when a few days after illness, when you are up on your feet and you feel great, and then you really want to thank the Lord. Otherwise, for months and years, if you have been keeping good health, we don't realize the value till we fall sick. Similarly, the dusthanas have been given to us to marginalize our issues or handle our issues or give us the ability to handle challenges and problems which the dusthana placements are throwing at us, the dusthana yogas are throwing at us, or dusthana lordships are throwing at us, and through that improving our karma and shedding the karmic debt. So never get scared of dusthana owning planets and where they are placed. Embrace them, understand them, and manifest them accordingly. Now, some planets will rule a dusthana but cannot rule a kendra at the same time. For example, Jupiter and Mercury, they cannot rule both a dusthana and a kendra at the same time, whatever placements they may be placed in. Whenever Jupiter rules one kendra, it will always rule another kendra. Same thing with Mercury. If Mercury rules one kendra, it will always rule another kendra. They cannot rule a dusthana and a kendra at the same time. However, they can rule a dusthana and a trine house at the same time. So, for example, for a Cancer ascendant native, Jupiter rules the sixth house as well as the ninth house. And for a Capricorn ascendant native, Mercury rules both the sixth house and the ninth house. So, these combinations are possible for Mercury and Jupiter, but they cannot rule a Kendra and a Upachaya house, or a Kendra or a Trine house, or a Kendra or a Dusthana at the same time. So in a way, these are also very good planetary energies because they are benefics. However, Jupiter and Mercury are opposing energies to each other. I have already made a video around it, so you may watch that video also. For example, Jupiter rules Sagittarius and the house bang opposite that is Gemini, ruled by Mercury. Jupiter rules Pisces and the house bang opposite that is Virgo, ruled by Mercury. And so these are opposing energies, and hence also they can be seen as benefics which can either rule Kendras or they can rule other combinations, but not a Kendra and a Dusthana, or a Kendra or a Trine house, or a Kendra or a Upachaya house. But what is important is which two houses a planet rules and which of the houses is a Mool Trikona house for them. Because the Mool Trikona house will always hold sway over the other house. Here we are not talking about exaltation houses, because exaltation houses are not owned by the planet. they are into some other sign except Mercury, which gets exalted in Virgo itself. So the general rule is that the Mool Trikona sign of a planet is more important when they rule a Dusthana in a trine house or a Dusthana or a Upachya house rather than vice versa. So whenever a planet rules its Mool Trikona sign is a trine house or a Kendra house, then it's supposed to be a very strong placement. But if a Mool Trikona sign rules the Dusthanas, the 6, 8 or 12 houses, then the planet will give more results of the 6, 8, 12 houses rather than of the other houses it rules. That's a simple rule, so stick to it. So for a Cancer ascendant native, Jupiter by virtue of ruling the 6th house and the 9th house will give more results or stronger results of the 6th house, which means challenges may also come by. There may be also sicknesses related to the 6th house, upheavals also, competitive situations every now and then, challenges from colleagues, issues in career, all those things will be seen. But by virtue of ruling the 9th house, if you do well about the 6th house, then the 9th house will click more for you. That is the best thing about a planet which rules the Dusthana and another house, especially if the Mool Trikona sign rules the Dusthana. You handle the negatives of the Dusthanas very well, you handle the challenge, the upheaval, the traumas well, then the other sign or the other house gives much, much better results. And so whenever any planet rules a Dusthana and any other house, be very, very careful to have least expectations from the Dusthana house, whether it is the 6th house or the 8th house or the 12th house. Keep in mind that expect least from about these house and contribute more, give selfless service, don't get into the unethical side of that house, don't get into unnecessary issues with the relationship which that particular house signifies. And then keep patience, ensure that you do more service of that house with lowest expectancy, and then you will find that the other house rules gives better results. So for a Cancer ascendant native, if you handle competition very well, you don't get into unnecessary arguments with people, you handle your colleagues very well at work, you treat the people who work for you below you very well, and you keep your good health, because 6th house is good health, then you will find that over a period of time Jupiter will give you much, much better results, because Jupiter also rules the 9th house. And keep good relations with your father also, because Jupiter rules the 9th house here. So being ethical, morally correct, especially when any planet rules the Dusthanas and any other house, and Mool Trikona sign rules the Dusthanas, then the simple thing, there is no other getting away from it. In fact, it's a good placement, because you are shedding your karmic debt, you are equalizing your karma, and then you are also opening up the doors of fate later on life. What more you want? Shedding of the karma and getting good karma. And that's what the Dusthana owning Mool Trikona sign of a planet gives you. So don't worry about it, but make use of it. Now for a planet which rules a Dusthana, it can easily get into a Vipreet Rajyog by ruling in the 6th, 8th or 12th house and going into any of these houses. But don't be confused or fooled by the Vipreet Rajyog, the term Rajyog, because irrespective of whether it Rajyog, Vipreet Rajyog is created or not, the upheavals will still come by. The only thing is you will get slightly better results after going through the upheavals, in fact more upheavals, because it is a Vipreet Rajyog. So a yoga, good yoga will also test you. It's not no easy, no free meal here, no free burgers here. So in a Vipreet Rajyog, the initial time will be more challenging, more trouble prone, and later on it will be very, very good results, and that's why it is a Rajyog. A Rajyog which means initial challenges and later success. I have also made a video on Vipreet Rajyog of how planets give results, especially when they are ruling a Dusthana and getting into another one. Please watch that. The other thing is, where is the planet actually placed if it rules one Dusthana and any other house, especially if the Dusthana has a Mool Trikona sign. For example, for a Taurus ascendant native, Jupiter rules both the 8th house and the 11th house. 8th house is a Dusthana, whereas the 11th house is an Upachya house. But the 11th house also rules your wishes and desires. Now, basis where Jupiter's placement is, it shows that if we handle the trauma, the upheaval, the challenges wherever Jupiter is placed, then the desires of that house can be met later. So for a Taurus ascendant native, if Jupiter gets even into a exaltation sign in the third house in Cancer, yet because it rules the 8th house and the 11th house, it means that initial part of your life you will have obstacles, you will face challenges, there will be upheavals, but through a transformation of how you handle those energies, later on all your aspirations related to the 8th house and the 11th house will come through with effort and through good communication, marketing yourself well, doing short journeys, and a struggle prone but very good success later is what Jupiter getting into exaltation sign in Cancer for a Taurus ascendant native is seen when Jupiter rules the 8th house and the 11th house. So that's how you should see the results of planets when they rule two houses and not in a simple way. Now I'm giving you the most challenging placements first, because it is the challenging placement, especially where one of the houses is the Dushthana, which troubles more, especially if the Dushthana is ruled by a Mool Trikona sign. Same thing with Mercury. For example, for a Capricorn ascendant native, Mercury rules the 6th house and it rules the 9th house. So it rules a Dushthana and it rules the 9th house. However, unlike Jupiter, where its first sign is its Mool Trikona sign, for Mercury, its second sign Virgo is its Mool Trikona sign and not the first one, which is Gemini. So for a Capricorn ascendant native, Gemini rules the 6th house and Virgo rules the 9th house. So what does it mean? It means that Mercury rules the 9th house as its Mool Trikona sign and the 6th house as a other sign. So the 9th house sign has an upper hand, and based where it is placed, Mercury will give you more results of the 9th house than rather than the 6th. However, you will always get dual results here. So if the Mool Trikona sign is a better house, then more results of better value results will come from there, and lesser value results from the Dushthanas. So for example, for a Capricorn ascendant native, wherever Mercury is placed, luck will come through you through effort, through analysis, through problem solving wherever Mercury is placed, but there will also be issues, there will also be challenges, there will also be competition wherever Mercury is placed from the 6th house, which is of competition. However, excelling in competitive exams also will be good for you. However, when Mercury rules the 6th house and the 3rd house for Aries ascendant native, here the Mool Trikona sign is ruled by the Mool Trikona sign of Mercury rules the 6th house. But Mercury is extremely powerful in the 6th house because it is its natural house. In spite of that, wherever Mercury is placed, because it ruled the 6th house, challenges will still come through to you. However, you will be able to overcome those challenges. That's why Mercury does very well in the 6th house in Virgo. No other planet can do very well there. I'll make a separate video on which planets are strongest in the Kendras, which planets are strongest in the Upachaya houses, which planets are strongest in the Trine houses, and which planets are strongest in the Dushthanas as well. This is a series I'm contemplating so that it's easy for us to understand how to manifest those results. Today I'm talking about how to manifest results when planets rule two houses and how we should see them. So here, for Aries ascendant native, Mercury ruling the 6th house as well as the 3rd house and placed wherever will give you good results of the 6th house, but through upheavals, through challenges and through sicknesses also. So sickness related to the part where Mercury is placed in may come by every now and then. So for example, if Mercury is placed in the 10th house, then you may have challenges of the knees, or there may be pain in the knees, later on arthritis also. If it's in the 11th house, then calves can give you challenges. If it's in the 12th house, then feet can give you challenges, especially because Mercury gets debilitated in Pisces in the 12th house, then feet can give you problems again and again. So you should keep that in mind and should bear that in mind, and you should take proper care of feet where for Aries ascendant native, because Mercury rules the 6th house. For an Aries ascendant native, Mars rules the 1st house and the 8th house. So again rules the 8th house, which is the Dushthana, but the Dushthana is not a Mool Trikona sign. However, on the other hand, for a Virgo ascendant native, Mars rules the 8th house and also rules the 3rd house. Here the 8th house is ruled by it's a moon trikona sign, which is Aries. So wherever Mars is placed, obstacles will be there, upheavals will be there, initial challenges will be there. However, through effort, which Mars also rules the third house, through effort, through proper communication, through self-enterprise, through dedication, through committed effort and not giving up, in spite of all these upheavals, later on you will get very good success. Mars is the strongest planet which can deal with the upheavals of the 8th house. So, if you are a Virgo ascendant native, then use the Mars energies to overcome the challenges and issues and upheavals which the 8th house is bringing to you. But if a planet rules a Dusthana and goes into any Upachaya house, then it is a guaranteed good result later on in life, but after a lot of struggles. Keep that in mind. So a planet which is ruling a Dusthana, especially if it's Dusthana is a Mool Trikona sign, and then getting into the 3rd house, the 6th house, the 10th house, the 11th house, then over a period of time you will get very good results. If you sustain the effort and you continue to work hard and you don't give up, and you still keep your energy levels high, and you don't compromise on your principles and your values. Now, for a Scorpio ascendant native, Venus rules the 7th house, and Venus also rules the 12th house. So here, by ruling the 7th house, which is a Kendra house, but also ruling the 12th house, which is a Dusthana, this seems to be a challenging result. However, if you note that Venus is the only planet which gets exalted in the 12th house in a Dusthana. So, can you imagine a planet getting exalted in a Dusthana and still bringing fantastic results? Venus, Mercury, obviously, because it rules Virgo. But Venus in the 12th house gives better results than Mercury in the Virgo from a materialistic point of view, from a worldly point of view. Venus in the 12th house can bring you fantastic results from foreign clients, foreign consultants in foreign lands, and it can give you a fantastic life, a life of high value also, a life of quality. The only challenge here is that Venus here sometimes makes the person not hold on to the money and has a free hand, which means you spend too much money on luxuries and you overspend sometimes, and later on you may always have a dearth of money there. However, Venus in the 12th house means it keeps giving you the money and you keep splurging the money. So the high quality life is there. However, if you slip even a little bit in terms of your ethical moral values, how you treat the opposite gender, whether you get into gambling, whether you get into too much drinking, you get into drugs, anything that you spoil Venus attributes of, or you don't keep hygiene, you don't talk nicely, your language is not good, superfluous and soft and polished, suave, sophisticated, then it hits back very hard. So be very, very careful when Venus is in the 12th house, especially for a Scorpio ascendant native, because the Mool Trikona sign and exaltation but can give you a great life, but can also hit you equally back hard if you don't get it right. But the challenge here is more for Aries ascendant native, where Mercury rules a Dusthana, which is the 6th house, and gets into the 12th house, where it's debilitated. And so though it creates a Viparita Raj Yoga, this is not the best of placements to have, because Mercury loses a lot of its benefic results and it gets into a challenging area with relation to the 12th house. So it's not easy for you to control your expenses, it's not easy for you to get out of problems. Authorities may keep chasing you, you may get court notices, you may not get great results in foreign lands. However, you can be very, very creative, you can have very good artistic abilities in communication, in writing, more of the imaginary kind, the fictitious kind, rather than the data oriented, rather than analytical oriented. So if you write a book on commerce while Mercury is debilitated in the 12th house, you may get hardly any good results. But if you write a story or a fictitious book, a novel, when Mercury is in the 12th house, something very artistic, creative, then you can get much better results, literary success, but after some overhaul in your life, after facing challenges, issues and competition, because it's 6th house is also involved, because Mercury ruled the 6th house. So after a lot of upheavals and challenges, later on success in life is what Mercury debilitated in the 12th house shows, but in a imaginary, in artistic, in a creative endeavor, rather than a non-fictional, analytical, data-oriented one. Now for planets which rule one Kendra and another Kendra, it is easy for you. However, when planets rule two Kendras like Jupiter and Mercury do, for whoever you see, whether you see for a Gemini ascendant native, a Virgo ascendant native, or a Sagittarius ascendant native, or a Pisces ascendant native, Jupiter will rule the Kendra houses as well as Mercury will rule the Kendra houses. So they will give good results as long as they are placed very well. However, there will also be initial hiccups, because whenever planet rules two Kendra houses, one signification of the house will always be under challenge, will always be under duress. Find out what challenge you are facing if you are a Gemini ascendant native or a Virgo ascendant native or a Sagittarius or a Pisces ascendant native, either about Mercury or Jupiter, about those particular houses, which is that signification where you face most challenges in related to the Kendras, and work in the direction and keep better patience and keep better behavior, better attitude about this. Over a period of time, you will get slightly better results, but not the best results if one of the attributes is challenged, is spoiled, or under duress. Planets which rule a Kendra house and a trine house, like a Saturn does, can give you fantastic results, but after a lot of labor, as Saturn represents. Planets which rule a trine house and an Upachaya house, for example, Mercury rules the trine house, which is the 9th house, and the Upachaya house, which is the 6th house, for a Capricorn ascendant natives. Gemini is the sign which rules the 6th house, and Virgo is the sign which rules the 9th house. So here you have a trine house ruled by Mercury, and you have a 6th house, which is the Upachaya house ruled by Mercury. Here too, over a period of time, you get very, very good results, because the trine house is the Mool Trikona sign of Mercury. So look at results from a combination of planets, whether a trine house and a Kendra is involved, like Saturn can bring you, or a trine house and an Upachaya house is involved, or Kendra houses are involved, or Upachaya houses and Kendra houses are involved also. So look at how the placements bring you. Upachaya houses will bring you gains after struggle and over upheaval over a period of time and sustained effort. Dusthanas will also do the same for you, but Dusthanas will challenge you more. Dusthanas will test you more, but the results will be sweeter and better over a period of time. So friends, that's how you see the results which come from planets which rule two houses. Especially look into which house is the Mool Trikona sign that overrules the challenges of the Dusthana houses, but it's the opposite way. If the Dusthana house is the Mool Trikona house, then the challenges will obviously be more. So keep that in mind and then manifest the results accordingly. But wherever planets are placed, if you make a life of principles or values, helping others, being grateful, submitting to the supreme energy, always being of service to others, always helping others, smiling in the most challenging of situations, keeping your patience, expecting least from everybody, expecting least from your job, but continuing to aspire for more, then over a period of time, you will see keeping the relationships also intact, treating the respective relationship well, you will get success, if not sooner than later, but it will be sweeter. So look into your own horoscopes and decide for yourself where you stand. If you're looking for a consultation from me, please reach out to me at the links given below. And till some other time with some other video, this is your friend, astrologer and guide Irfan, signing off. Ciao.